time to get that briefcase and go.
Thank you.
that it?
Hey! Who's there?
Money.
Shit. For a second there, I thought you were one of those demons. The National Guard barricaded us inside here before they headed off to protect the company office. If you want to find the man in charge, you need to use that crane to move those crates.
Taking it. Like a charm.
Thanks for letting us out.
The office. Where is it?
I need the man in charge. There's no way to get there from here.
Unless you use the zip line from the top of that tower. That'd be crazy.
Please, you gotta help my buddies. Once you get on the other side, just follow the pipes. It's a kind of maze, but just keep going.
So glad you made it, sir.
I'll take it.
bless you, sir.
I can go see my family now.
After a closer examination, I believe these trust documents are suspect. Every 30 years, the property rights are transferred to the next generation. However, I believe that Peter DeBono has likely been deeding them to himself for who knows how many years. Sincerely yours, Jonathan Q. Biddle.
Almost there. Out of my way. Jesus.
of a ride. What did I say? Oh yeah, follow the pipes.
Thank you.
About time someone sent in the cavalry. I've been hiding here for a week.
This ain't a rescue mission, so watch your mouth. I'm here to pick up some documents for Assistant Secretary Harrow.
Documents? I don't know anything about any documents. Oh, these documents?
You must be the accountant.
Jonathan Q. Biddle at your service. Mr. Harrow promised me immediate backup, as long as I kept this safe.
Harrow's written you off, Biddle. Sent me for the case, not you. All I know is that DC wants that portfolio seized.
DC? What an asshole. Harrow isn't trying to leverage this property for the government, you ape. He wants it for himself. He wrote me into this scheme for a cut of the profits, and now he's hung me out to dry. That asshole.
How big a cut?
10%.
Hope it was worth all those soldiers' lives, you greedy little pissworm. I'll take that.
Whoa, wait! What about me? How'll I get home?
Walk. Turning the tide's my ass. More like lining your own pockets, you slimy shit.
What the hell are you... Biddle. Oopsie-daisy.
You sent 24 National Guardsmen to their deaths for a paycheck. When the president gets wind of this, you're a dead man.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's just that the way the veins in your forehead are throbbing, it's so comical.
Mr. Assistant Secretary, these accusations sound serious, and...
First of all, it's Mr. Secretary now, as in Secretary of War, as in the fucking right hand of God. Secondly, do you think the President of these United States is gonna give a royal fuck about the pissant accusations of a podunk... Go ahead, Rentier, do it. Give me a reason to throw your cowpoke ass into Newgate and flens your father's legacy to the bone. The Harrow Institute has a much better ring to it, don't you think?
Mr. Secretary, maybe it would be for the best if you...
Maybe it would be best if you stopped interrupting me, you groveling mule! You want to make yourself useful? Get to the kitchen and fetch me a cup of coffee! Now fuck off and find some vampires to kill. That's much more your speed. You want something done right, you gotta do it yourself. Bunch of useless clowns.
Real war is coming? Full-blown war with the ticks? Your Dr. Blackwell deserves...
The news is spreading fast.
Until we get free of those paper pushers in D.C.
Yeah, well, I bet they wouldn't be so cocky if a tick came knocking on the White House door.
Probably not. But that would mean we failed.
That's alarming.
I'm surprised voltage that high didn't burn it out.
It's all about the percentage of copper in the alloy. Yeah, I'll show you my notes.
Seriously? I would love to see your original research. It would be an honor.
Virgil and I were just having the most invigorating discussion.
I was telling Director Rentier about my ideas for upgrading the gauntlet.
I must say, it's refreshing to see young blood like Mr. Olney's coursing through Calico. We'll need his vital spirit if we're to rebuild the Institute's power and vigor. Well done, son.
I think we may have given him a few too many vaults.
Glad to see you're in good shape, but we've got a situation. In order to keep your condition quiet, Amelia told Harrow you died. He's pulled rank and is sending us out on money-grubbing errands while Felicity's building her army.
Harrow's head knows what's right, but his heart is tainted by lust for power and money.
It's gonna get worse now that he got promoted. One wrong move and we're dead in the water.
The one right move, and you could catch her and end this war. On the subject of moving...
You know what? Maybe let's wait for the doc to give the all clear before we start unbinding anyone.
Oh, Edgar. Harrow's not an idiot. Without the Institute, this country would turn into a blood feast. Now, you tell me, son. What's more important? His approval or ending this war before it started?
What did you see while Felicity was in your head?
Death. Horrible monsters appearing out of nowhere.
fire, smoke, everything. And boxcars. Scores of filled with blood.
That's how she's transporting the leeches now? By train?
That's not good, sirs. Dickinson is a major cattle railway hub. The trains run in all directions. If there's an outbreak, we won't be able to contain it.
Jesus Christ, what happened here?
Thank you. tracks across the continent, but you're still the same violent beast you've always been. You just invented bigger and better clocks.
Between you and me, you little leech. Let them go.
Humans build empires in the name of progress, with no thought spared for those paying the mortal cost of their quest for glory. That is true vampirism! My kind would never leave one of their children to die, crying in the gutter.
I won't let you turn them.
You don't listen! They don't matter, Jesse Rente. The sooner you understand that, the better. Chewing through the pathetic remains of your fathers.
What now? You too scared to face me in your own flesh?
Humanity exists within cycles. If you live long enough, you notice the patterns that govern it. The pendulum may swing left and right, but ultimately things remain the same. Exploitation, pain, and misery. It may look different, but it persists. The only way out is to break that pattern.
You
I got you now.
All aboard! The train's about to leave the station. Do you hear them singing? That's humanity's requiem. You can be mankind's last sad note, or you can be part of a new opening chord of progress. It's only natural to feel fear while standing on the precipice of change.
Sometimes what you need is a little push. Try not to kill him, my child. Let it break poor William's heart.